Again, same thing. Only one auto response rule can be activated a single time. There can be multiple rule entries, and in every rule entry, there is a criteria. If the criteria is true, and in that case, an email will be sent. And the criteria is false, and in that case, another rule entry. With the criteria. That's how it goes. Is it clear to everyone? Case auto response rules. New.
Oh, sorry.
If the case reason is feedback or any other, send a thank you email. Select the email template that you want to send. Save it. Right? Whose email is working? Okay. Sorry, 270 at what's the problem? Submit. Check whether you got the email or not. So this is how you can create auto response rules. Again, exactly similar to lead auto response rules, right? Will you get an auto response rule working when you'll register a case manually? You sure? That was the case with leads. What about cases? Not every time. Okay, so let's see. Assign using active assignment tool. So if you're creating a record and if you want it to be assigned according to the assignment rule, then check this. Else keep it unchecked. Right? That's the first thing. Second, send notification email to contact. That basically means that if you're gonna check this, then in that case the contact will get a notification email. So with the notification email that person will get. Will be according to the auto response rule, or will be according to, or is there any standard email that is drafted and the person will get that? Standard email or auto response rule? Let's see. So Ayush, I'm going to send you another email, right? And your email ID is Ayush Khandel. Ayush2709@gmail.com. Any phone, nothing. I'm gonna sign it according to this, and I'm gonna send notification email to contact like this. Right. Let's see if the email is right. Yeah, it is. Same. Oh, by the way, we didn't select the reason. The reason should be feedback. Let's save it. One. I'll have to create Ayush as my account or contact. Let me first do that. Let's say this guy works at Volkswagen. Now I'm going to go and create a new case. Feedback, origin. Email. Should I just send it? It is already new one. Say. So now what you have to do is you have to check that both the emails are same or are they different. Definitely. Whenever you create a new case record, a new case number gets assigned and it's a system generated auto number that you cannot even modify. Different, eh? But the condition was same. Right? So auto response rules, listen to this very carefully. Auto response rules work only with web to lead or web to case basically. Auto response rules, lead auto response rules only work with web to lead. Case auto response rules only work with web to case. Right? But there is an additional functionality with cases that if you're going to check this send email to contact, it is going to set a predefined email to the contact which is registering that particular case in our org. Is it clear, everyone? Okay. When it comes to case, there is again a status field, case status, that can be controlled with the help of support process. Support process. Here is support process. I'll go to setup and hit support process. And I'm going to create new. Yeah, I mean, there are two different types of cases that we register. Software issue. In that case, we automatically start working, let's say. And when there is hardware issue, I mean, there are all the steps. So these are the two support processes that I've created. Now, in order to use the support process, what I'm going to do? Create a record type for case object. And how we can do that? Go to object manager, case, record types, new. Okay. I'm going to select hardware issues support process. Let's change the name first, because there might be a confusion that might happen at which one is what. Edit. Hardware support process, it's a software support process. Now go to the case object in object manager, go to record types, create a new one. Hardware issue and select the hardware support process. I didn't make it enable for everyone. The page layout is definitely going to be case layout. Save. Software support process. Active. Enable for all profiles. Next. Select the case layout. Now if you're gonna go to case and create a new case, hardware issue. All the four statuses are coming, new, working, escalated and closed. Let's create a software issue. There's no new in. That's it. So the value of case status field is controlled by which process? Exactly. That's what is important, by the way. In interviews of a consultant, of an administrator, these are the questions that are asked, right? Which process? We know that it is managed by process, but we need to know specifically because it's not associated to the object. Lead one definitely is lead process. But what is sales process? So they might ask you this question in two different perspectives. What is sales process in the perspective of a business person or a business user? And what is a sales process in Salesforce? So you have to answer it in both ways, right? Or you can just answer it like, which perspective are you talking about, in Salesforce or in general? So in general, then talk about the business perspective. In Salesforce, then talk about that it can control the stage field on opportunity object, right? The values and the stages of in the opportunity object, and similarly support process, right? So that's how it goes. Is it clear?